Good afternoon. So my name is Jay Kumar. So working as an assistant professor and placement officer in AVS College of Arts and Science. So today I'm going to explain about a group discussion. So before enter into the group discussion, so you should aware about what is the main purpose of most of the MNC companies. Okay, most of the companies that hiring a group discussion as one of the selection process. So the main purpose of this group discussion is it is one of the communication test selection process. Okay. So why HR prefer this group discussion selection process and what is the main expectation of this group discussion selection process? So the main expectation of the group discussion is, so most of the HR, they expect only three qualities from your side. The first one is they will test self-confident level, and second is they will test your communication skills, and third one is your leadership skills. Okay, so these are all the main important things you have to prove in front of the recruiters at the time of group discussion selection process. Okay, so how to prove these three qualities in front of the HR at the time of selection process? So if you want to prove you are a highly self-confident person, the first thing you have to do is, so how much you speak loudly, that is most important things. So if your voice is very high, it means that you are very confident. So what information you are trying to convey others, so you have to increase your volumes. So how much you increase your volume, that much what shows you are a very confident person. So if you want to show I am a 100% self-confident, means you should increase your volume. That is the first thing. And second thing, if you prove that you have a good communication skill, you should concentrate on your sentence formations. So what is sentence formations? So at the time of group discussion, you should not say a single word answer, yes, no. That is what not necessary. So you have to make a lengthy sentence, okay? But your sentence should be very legible. Okay, what informations you are going to convey, that should be a not single word, it should be a lengthy sentence. That is what most important. Okay, and multiple times you have to contribute at the group discussion. If you are present one time and two times, that is what not good. Okay, so if you want to prove you have a good communication skill, means so multiple times your contribution is what needed. Okay, and third one is leadership skill. So how to prove leadership skill in front of the recruiters at the time of group discussions? So what is the quality of leaders? So leader should have a clear vision, and main thing is, so you have to achieve the target. Okay, he should continuously motivate his team members. That is what leadership do. So at the time of group discussion, you should motivate each and every person in your group discussion. You should encourage your persons in the group discussion. And also, you should access valid points from others, and you should give a consolidated report at the time of conclusions. So these are all the qualities of leaders. So main thing is, if you want to act as a leader at the time of group discussion, you should be an encourageable person. Okay, you should give a clear ideas about the group discussion, you take an initiative, you should be a concluder. So each and everything is what you have to do. The main thing is encourage every person in the group discussions. So these are all the three main qualities you have to prove at the time of group discussion. And also HR will test these three things. These are all the main three things what HR expert at the time of group discussion. And next is, so what are all the things you have to do's and don'ts at the time of group discussions? Okay, so do's is, so you should be very clear. So most of them doing this continuous mistakes, your eye contact. Okay, so you should be view each and every person in the group discussions. Okay, that is most important thing. And second is your body language. So what information you are trying to convey, that information should be explained your body language. That is what most important. And third one is sentence formation. So in sentence formation, without any grammatical mistakes. Okay, each and every sentence, each and every words, that should be very legible, that should be very clear. You should be deliver the statements to the outside, then only others should able to understand. Okay, so these three are the main thing you have to focus. And what are all the things you don'ts? So important things you don'ts at the time of group discussion is, don't dominate others. Okay, that is very, very dangerous. You don't do at the time of group discussions. Okay, don't dominate others. Don't say any negative statements. So if a group discussion is what 15 to 20 minutes means, so end of the session you have to take a positive statement only. So don't state any negative statements. That is what very, very important. Okay, so students, I will give the summarized report about the group discussion. So first thing you have to aware about, what is the main purpose of group discussion is, so group discussion is a communication test selection process. That should be, you should know. So you have to prove that you are a good communicator. Okay, that is the main objective of the group discussion. And what is the main expectation of the group discussion is, you have to prove three qualities from the HR at the time of, in front of the HRs. The first one is your confident level, and second one is your communication skill, and third one is your leadership skill. So these three are the main thing you have to focus at the time of group discussion. You should present in front of the HR also. So in order to prove you are a good self-confident person means increase your volume. How much you increase your volume, that much, that shows you are a very self-confident person. And second is communication skill. Don't say any single word, make lengthy sentences. And third one, leadership skill. If you want to prove a leader, you should encourage each and every person in your team. And do's and don'ts. So main thing do's is, give importance to your eye contact and body language and sentence formations. And don't is, don't say any negative statements at the time of group discussions. If you follow these things, definitely you will clear group discussion. HR will recruit you. You are a very quality person. Okay. And finally, I want to share two things. So at the time of group discussion, so don't give up these two things to any person. The first one is the initiator, and second one is concluder. Okay, you should be an initiator, you should give the conclusions. So these two things is what very, very important at the time of group discussion. Don't give this chance to anyone. Thank you.